Financial Sense Insider is a premium subscription service of PFS Group. The following is a free preview of today's Insider interview.
Well, for investors, you could probably say this is the best of times and the worst of times. If you want to finance a home, rates have never been cheaper. If you're retired trying to live off income from your investments, well, these are miserable times. Joining us from CNBC is Rick Santelli. And Rick, I'm looking at interest rates here at 2.2. I know we do fixed income, laddered portfolios for our clients. We're completely out of the bond market. There's no way I am going to lock in on a laddered bond, let's say munis, at 1.5% or 2% for a 10-year period. Doesn't make sense at all.
It doesn't, but let's look at the facts. And believe me, I completely understand, because every time any investor or strategic portfolio manager sits down on any given day, looks up at the board, they all think the same thing. Why would I lend my money to Uncle Sam for 10 years for a little over 2%? But here's the problem with that. That, Jim, for 2014, and I'm looking at a live screen based on yesterday's settlement prices, the year to date, and here's the key term, total return for a 30-year is 24%. For a 10-year, it's 10.5%. The Dow just nudged yesterday back into positive territory, and it's up a little bit today. So the point is that when investors or any of your listeners just look at the paltry yield, and I understand it's paltry unless you're comparing it to European yields, which are more paltry, at least based on the sovereigns in the Eurozone, you're missing half the picture, and half the picture has been the price appreciation, and that's what total return encompasses. It not only includes your biannual interest payments, we all know what the rate was, like we both said, a little over two, but the price appreciation really has kicked in. Now, will it continue? Most likely not, but I do remember the third and fourth quarters of 2013. I don't think anybody anticipated that total returns for 30-year bonds could actually rival the return of the S&Ps last year at a bit over 30%.
But, you know, the flip side of that, Rick, is last year when we first got the taper tantrums and we saw the long bond go from 1.6 to 3%, you know, if you were in treasuries like TLT or LQD, bond investors got a taste of what happens when it goes in the opposite direction.
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's financialsense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.